Good morning, everybody. Thanks so much to join us. I'm Domenico Fabiomasi, Marketing Manager for Telit EMEA. Today we are presenting Telit non-cellular portfolio, Bluetooth and LoRa product. I would like to introduce you today the presenter, Eric Lagors, Senior Product Manager, IoT for non-cellular product. And just for your information, a recorded version of this webinar will be available, and also the presentation. Eric, feel free to start when you want, and thank you and join our webinar.
Good morning, everybody. So, as Domenico said, I will present an update on the Bluetooth portfolio and also an update on the our LoRa offering. Okay. So let's start by the Bluetooth. Okay. So on the Bluetooth, we have a roadmap for dual mode, so supporting Bluetooth Classic and Bluetooth Low Energy. So in terms of product, we have the BlueMode SR, which is a 4.20, so supporting Bluetooth Classic and Bluetooth Low Energy 4.0, with antenna or without antenna. The product is hosted, means that you need an external microcontroller and you command through AT command. The latest product, which is the BL871E2-HI, it's a host controller interface module. So it means that it's a transceiver module with an integrated antenna, crystal, filtering, and so on. But you need an external stack running on the host microprocessor. So the stack microprocessor can be Linux, Android, or can be FreeRTOS. On the Bluetooth single mode roadmap, so we have a set of different modules versus functionality supported. So on the same form factor, we have the BlueMode S-AI, which is a Bluetooth 4.1 module. Then we have the BlueMode S42 with integrated antenna, which is a 4.2 module. We have the BlueMode S42M, which is a peripheral Bluetooth Low Energy 4.2 with the capability to embed several sensors like free axis accelerometer, temperature and humidity. We release early this year the BlueMode S50, which is a BLE5 module with and without antenna version. And we have in the concept phase a BlueMode plus S5 long range. So I will come later to explain on the Bluetooth 5 the difference, which is on the same form factor. And we have on the concept phase the same module on a reduced form factor. So just a summary of the Bluetooth family of product. So all these products, BlueMode SR, BlueMode S42, S42M, and S50 are pin-to-pin compatible. So the BlueMode SR is, as I said, it's a Bluetooth 4.0 qualified dual mode module supporting SPP profile, GAT, and the terminal I/O. So terminal I/O is I will say it's a point-to-point communication on the proprietary on the BLE side. I will explain later. The BlueMode S42 is a Bluetooth 4.2 low energy. So the chipset, it's Nordic base. So you have the capability to do NFC and capable with the Nordic SDK. And the BlueMode S42, we are offering with a different set of firmware supporting hosted version with terminal I/O, GAT services. We offer also a complete standalone version, which is automation I/O profile. And we offer also a complete hosted solution, adding Lua script language. I will come later on this. The BlueMode S42M is a low-cost module with capability to embed sensor, as I said before. It's based on the Realtek chipset, so it's Bluetooth 4.2 low energy. Essentially, we implement in our software the GAT server, so it's a pure peripheral low-end device. And the latest one, which is the BlueMode S50, based on the Nordic chipset, but we implement all the services, the GAT services, client server, including also our proprietary terminal I/O peripheral and central. And we support the 2 megabyte physical layer for the LE on this version. So what I said as a summary, what is interesting, it's the software feature supported by the different devices. So you can see that all the modules are pin-to-pin compatible. The only difference could be 0.1 millimeter for the antenna. The BlueMode S42, S50 Nordic base are in industrial temperature, minus 40, 85, while the BlueMode S42M, it's consumer temperature, minus 20, plus 70 degrees. All the BLE are between 1.8 volt to 3.6 volt. In terms of operation, the BlueMode S42 and the S50 can handle concurrently peripheral and central services, while the BlueMode S42, it's only peripheral. So you will have only GAT server on the BlueMode S42M, while you will have a GAT client and GAT server for the BlueMode S50. After that, you have a different set of peripheral. So it will depend on the software version that some of the peripherals are managed or not. So just to explain, so the BlueMode SR, which is a Bluetooth dual mode, there is no everything is hosted, so inside is based on the microcontroller and the transceiver, and we load our Telit stack. While after that, the BlueMode S42, S50 based on the Nordic chipset. So I provide some reference in terms of consumption in sleep current and also on the advertising channel, on the free channel advertising, sorry. So based on the Nordic and the BlueMode S42M, you have the characteristic of the Realtek chipset. So the main difference between the BLE, it's more or less the chipset capability in terms of computing and also in terms of performances. You can see that we reach 5 dBm conducted with the Nordic, while we reach only 0 dBm for the Realtek base. In terms of software feature, I already mentioned that we have a set of capability for the BlueMode S42. So GAT, terminal I/O, peripheral central. We have the automation I/O, which is the standalone capability. So we provide also a mobile app for that. And we have the Lua IoT platform. BlueMode S50 supports also all the GAT and the terminal I/O, and the same for BlueMode S42M. The only difference is that it's only GAT server supported for the S42M. In terms of certification, BlueMode S42 is already is certified RED, FCC, IC, KCC, MIC, Anatel, IRC, M-Mark. Will extend also to other country. The BlueMode S42M is we extend the certification. Originally, it was only Taiwan, China, and we extend to Europe, FCC, IC, so US and Canada. And the BlueMode S50, which is the latest product release, BlueMode Bluetooth 5, for the moment, it's only covering Europe, US, and Canada. Something I would like to mention, you probably heard this summer that there is a Bluetooth Zig Eratum that concern some vulnerability in terms of public key transmit during the pairing procedure. So they release an errata and we implement this fix on all our modules. So Bluetooth 4.2 and BLE5. So concretely, BlueMode, all the new software release, I would say starting in August, BlueMode S42, S50 and S42M, because it concerns only starting at 4.2 standard, support this errata. So let's now go to the Bluetooth 5, because we talk. There is a lot of question regarding the Bluetooth 5. So this is the main feature. So increase the bandwidth. So I would say it's pure physical layer, and you you save some time on air to transmit data. After that, the second target is to increase the range. So in a way, enter an home automation or home application. So which is to increase the range by dividing the modulation. After that, you have the broadcasting channel improvement, which is message capability over Bluetooth 4.2. And you have the slot availability mask, which is more related to Bluetooth Classic. So this is all the Bluetooth 5 feature. What is important to understand on the Bluetooth 5 feature, that all these features are optional, okay? And if you want to take benefit, you need to support on both sides. So when you have a product which is Bluetooth 5 certified, you know that the chipset and is Bluetooth 5 and the stack, but you don't know exactly what is supported. So concretely, our BlueMode S50 support only the 2 MB physical layer and not the LE long range. Let's focus on the latest product we release, which is the Bluetooth 5. So as I said, it's a full industrial temperature range, so -40-85, real 1.8 operation, because we can go to up to down to 1.7 volt. We support GAT client, GAT server. For sure, we support also all the security. We have also a concurrent client and server operation, so we can handle four connections at the same time, three on the client and one on the peripheral. In terms of data throughput over BLE, what we call a terminal I/O, and I will explain later what is the terminal I/O. We can achieve up to 700 kilobit per second data throughput. In terms of performances, the BlueMode S50, we did some outside line of sight test, so at 1.5 meter in good condition, and we have up to 850 meter between two BlueMode S50. Roughly, if you take an Android mobile phone or an iPhone, we can reach outside between 250 and 300 meters. Okay. So in terms of software, we also implement NFC for simple pairing. We have the firmware over the air. We develop this SPP-like over BLE, which is a terminal I/O. On the mobile side, we can provide also sample code for iOS and Android to implement it. And we also implement a low power UART interface control protocol. It's mainly to when you are in hosted mode, to improve the current consumption, shutting down some of the peripheral and the UART. Terminal I/O, so on Bluetooth Classic, they define SPP. On Bluetooth Low Energy, they do not define this kind of profile. So it's similar to SPP, serial port profile. Terminal I/O, it's a simple point-to-point solution for a use case that requires transparent data exchange and transport of GPIO level signal change. So it's a GET-based LE profile in conjunction with our UART interface control protocol to manage low power. So you have over-the-air flow control, authentication, encryption. And as I said just before, it's the application we provide on application source code for Android and iOS. Okay. So this terminal IO is running on all the TELIT module starting from the BlueMode SR, BlueMode S, S42, S42M, and S50. I would say the only difference. Sorry. So the only difference will be in a way in terms of efficiency and throughput. So as an example, I give you some tests we did with the terminal IO versus in between two modules. So S42, for example, we can reach 500 kilobits per second. And if we do the same measurement using BlueMode S50 using the 2 megabyte modulation, we can reach 700 kilobits per second. And then after that, versus different mobile phone, it will depend essentially what support the mobile phone in terms of extending MTU. If the mobile phone, the latest one, support also the 2 megabyte. And there is also some limitation for the connection interval when you connect with the mobile. But more or less, you have the data. We can achieve around minimum 250 in uplink, up to 670. So I was saying that we provide also source code. So we have a terminal IO utility. So it works not only for the S50, but also for the S42, S42M, and BlueMode S. So it's a very simple communication between a TELIT device and the mobile phone. So now let's back to the TELIT HEI module. So the BL871E2. It's a Bluetooth host control interface, means that it's a transceiver. So the transceiver is the TI-CC2564C. So it's integrated with antenna. And it's an ideal companion of any kind of MCU. So MCU could be FreeRTOS, and you can consider the MSP from TI. You can run the stack, and the BL871 is the perfect solution for this kind of application. After that, if you use Linux and Android, works also perfectly. We already do some tests, and we have some AVK, which is a TI booster pack, so a TI shield, so you can plug on the booster pack, so you can use TI stack to do the test. And otherwise, we can also provide the BL871 with a Raspberry Pi, where we load our stack. So you can see on the Linux side that we support the Bluetooth Classic and the Bluetooth Low Energy, and do some tests. So let's see now on the BLE side, the development model. There is, in a way, a free model. You have your own microcontroller, so you connect all your sensors, you connect your battery, and through UART SPI, you drive the module, and you have the capability to use our BlueMode family. BLE, supporting BLE, Bluetooth, NFC, so it's a common 80 common set. And you have a module which is fully tested and maintained in terms of stack with a high quality firmware supporting general purpose application scenario. Then you have the second capability, which is I want to be completely standalone, so I do not need an external microcontroller. So in this case, we are offering the BlueMode S42. We add on top of the BlueMode S42 the Lua script language, and then you can develop simple application using Telit IoT App Zone or any kind of terminal, and you will build your script and your application. So it's very simple to use. And third option, we provide the module S42, S50, and S42M, and you are skilled on Bluetooth. You know well the low layer to manage power and also everything related to Bluetooth. In this case, you use the SDK from the Nordic or Realtek for the S42, S42M, and S50. So this is the different way to use the module. You know our AVK today, so we are working and we already have the first prototype. So we will launch, I guess, this December, first with the BlueMode S50 and then on the S42 Lua. So essentially, our new Bluetooth evaluation or development kit are Arduino based. So for the Lua, which is a standalone platform where you want to develop your own application and manage a GPIO, so sensor, we will provide the board like the picture with embedded temperature, humidity, accelerometer, light sensor, push button. So in this case, after that, you want to add additional sensor. You just have to take some Arduino shield from the market and plug on it. While when we will provide a hosted version, so we will provide the same board, but not populated with the sensor, and it will be an Arduino shield, so you can connect to an Arduino master and FOAT command develop your own application. Now let's go on explanation on our standalone platform, which is implemented on the S42, which is Lua. So what is Lua? Lua is a lightweight, powerful, efficient, and portable, fast, and small script. It supports object-oriented programming, okay. In a way, it's something which is very, very simple to use and very simple to make rapid prototyping design. So technology is implemented as a library in CleanC. It's a free software, so you can go directly to the lua.org, and it's heavily adopted in many industrial applications. So we implement on the S42, so the feature. So we use the latest version, which is 5.3.5. So it's built in compiler to generate binary code. We pre-compile binary code and you can execute on board the file system. So no need to copy to RAM. We are using the native support for Integer and the floating point from the Nordic. And in a way, you will build with a Lua terminal different file and file system. In term of architecture, okay? So everything is based on the Nordic chipset. So we use the Nordic SDK. On top of the Nordic SDK, we add the framework for the Lua. And adding all the functionality. What we can provide at the end is up to 20K of RAM and up to 32K of flash. So we have 32K is conservative. We have 40K, but we keep some K flash for future evolution. So this is the in term of BLE control. No, sorry, I missed the page two. Okay. So in term of BLE control. So all the IT commands that we provide for hosted mode are virtual, so can be reusable. So we implement all the terminal IO functionality. We have a configurable BLE GAT server, so configurable BLE GAP. So we have also the scan. In terms of onboard file system, so we have three onboard file system. And what is interesting that automatically you can also attach an external flash. So you can add more functionality and store more file. So it's automatically detected by the module during your design if you attach a flash to the SPI. So multiple file, library support, and auto start script. In terms of hardware resource, so you have a full power management. So you have eight digital GPIO. You have up to four analog digital converter channel. You manage also the I2C. You manage the SPI, and you manage the UART. So the main firmware feature. So as I said, it's for hostless battery-driven operation and simple application based on Lua 5.3.5, 32K of flash, 20K of RAM, simple development of script as a text file, so no complex toolchain needed. Script access to the same IT command that is available in hosted firmware version to control Bluetooth functionality and the script access to generic GAT server to allow definition of GAT services. So script access to the terminal IO implementation for easy data exchange, Bluetooth scanning functionality RSCC base. You have access to the I2C, to the analog, all the GPIO. Sorry. We use hardware floating point and we have a 32K file system for script storage and you can extend through an external one depending on the size you select. So in terms of tool that we provide on our website, we provide also a set of so for sure you have the documentation and also a set of demo application list. So this is a non-exhaustive one, but all the package you can find under the website. So now let's move to Laura. Okay, in term of product and roadmap. So we have the RE866 A1 European version, which is now certified LoRaWAN 1.02 and support LoRa, BLE 4.2 and NFC. So could be hosted platform, so I will explain after that later that it's you can connect through UART or we implement also the Lua, so you can develop your own application into the module. So this is released in mass production. So there is the North American version, so the stack is already certify LoRaWAN 1.02. We also have implemented regional parameter for India or the APAC cluster. So Europe and US is more or less the same platform. It's just a matter of different setting for the output power and different setting for the regional parameter. So this is the, I would say, the high-end product, LoRa plus BLE plus NFC. And then we plan to shrink this two module to the what we call the B3 version, which is only LoRaWAN. So in a way, to be the first two one are more platform with remote functionality via BLE for commissioning, provisioning, or reflash over the air, or direct access to some sensor connected to the module, while the B3 is more pure bitpipe LoRa that you will use to connect to your own microcontroller and use only LoRa functionality. So to make it simple, so LoRa or LoRa BLE plus NFC is the same module, same PCB. The only difference that on the LoRa plus BLE NFC, we are using the Nordic chipset with a lot of flash and RAM. So we manage all the BLE side, and we reuse all the BLE software that we develop on the S42. And we implement also the LoRaWAN inside, and we have the capability to use NFC as into our BLE module. And we have also the capability to add a secure element. While the LoRa module only, it's less flash, less RAM, without any BLE functionality, but still the capability to add a secure element. So LoRa module development model, in a way, it's more or less what I explained for the BLE side. So you have an external MCU, you want to use the RE866. So the RE866 can be Bluetooth, LoRa, NFC, or LoRa only. You just have to power, and with the set of commands, you manage your application, your sensor are connected to your external MCU. Second approach is to, I want to be completely standalone. So if I want to be completely standalone, I have a simple application, let's say like a metering application. I just want to manage some GPIO, pulse counter, and something like that. Very simple. Take the RE866. We implement also the Lua script language. So you have access to the LoRaWAN API. You have access to the UART, to the GPIO. So you can develop your own application. And the latest possibility, you are already using a Nordic chipset and you want to add LoRa functionality. So let's port your stack into the module, into the RE866, because you have already the BLE, you develop everything on BLE side. And let's provide the library from Telit, which is a library sign, in the sense that this library can work only with our module. So if you do the same design, even you copy the design and you try to use the library, it will never work. So this is in this case, you use the Nordic SDK, you port your stack, and you have access to the Telit library, and then you can develop your BLE plus LoRa scenario. I will not re-explain the Lua, but if we consider the RE866 Lua on main firmware feature, so it's designed for OSless battery driven operation. So we use the same Lua 5.3.5. Main difference compared to the BLE that we have more flash. So we have up to 100 kilobyte of flash to implement and run a custom script. So the same development of script as text file, no complex tool chain needed. You have access to external sensor via S2C or one analog digital converter. You have access also to four fully configurable GPIO, UART, and it's purely support standalone operation and configuration. Let's I will give you some LoRa feature for the North America because it's the latest one which we release. In a way, it's the same as the European. The only difference is the spreading factor low in US, but we need to start with a spreading factor 10, while in Europe you can use the spreading factor 12. It's just a matter to pass the FCC certification with the frequency hopping, because you need to change the channel. It's 400 milliseconds. So what is interesting on this platform, that we use the two TX chain. So we have one TX chain, which is low power, 2 dBm to 14, 15 dBm. And automatically, when you want to switch to high power up to 19 dBm, you use the PA boost mode. So the design is very flexible because you can be really low power, and if we compare to most of our competitors, they are using only one chain from 2 to 19 dBm. So if you want to have only 14 dBm and have only low power consumption, so around 42 milliamp, is the only way. In terms of consumption in receive mode, this is we support it's 11 milliamp. On the standby mode, it's below 2 micro, and when you are in a system off managed by external micro, you are below 1 microamp. So more or less for North America, this value, you have the same value for the European version. It's the same hardware structure. In terms of Bluetooth low energy, so the same for North America, Europe, Asia Pacific, or India. What we reuse in fact the BlueMode S42 firmware, what we call the central. So you have a GAT client plus terminal IO peripheral, so peripheral and central mode at the same time. We have a max output power, which is 5 dBm on conducted mode and minus 96 on the conducted. And so we have a nice link budget. And in terms of consumption, I give you some as a reference, but when we are off, we are at 0.9 microamp. And on the advertising on free channel, we are at 18 microamp. So over the air, you have the LoRa module, which is compatible with the BlueMode S42. So it's the same software, same chipset that we use. In terms of value proposition, so to make a conclusion on the LoRa side, so on the LoRa, we can offer a pure low-cost LoRa bitpipe modem with a high efficiency, low power mode. So the UART also, we implement the UICP, so low power mode also, firmware over the air, so programmable output power 4 dBm to 15, or use the PA boost mode and reach 19 dBm. So we can use as a hosted, and then we can go up to Bluetooth 4.2 plus NFC plus LoRa. So with all the BLE functionality for provisioning, remote management and FOTA, we have the capability to have an embedded secure element. We can use the NFC for easy pairing and activation. So, as I said just before, it's over the air compatible with our Bluetooth module. So in a way, you can use the module as a gateway on BLE side and have three and more on the future sensor connected to the RE866 and use LoRa communication to send the data to the server. We can reuse also the Terminal IO app utility, and we are flexible in terms of use because you can be hosted standalone reusing a Lua script language or use the Nordic SDK with the Telit Secure LoRa library. That's all for today.
Thank you, Eric. Thank you, everyone. It was a pleasure being with you today. For your information, next week we have another webinar hosted again by Eric and focus on GNSS portfolio and solution. Thank you so much. Have a nice day. Bye.
Domenico, there is no.
No, we don't have any question.
Okay. Okay, thank you. Ciao, ciao.